America isn't working when people's bills are too high, taxes are too high, and they have less take-home pay in their pockets. Our Democratic colleagues believe the answer to these problems is $1.8 trillion in tax hikes so they can spend more. That's not right and it's not fair. House Republicans have a better way to build an America that works. We passed bill after bill that helps create jobs, grow wages, and put money back into people's pockets. These bills, of course, are all stuck in the Senate, where partisan speeches take precedence over working middle-class families. This week, the House will consider our budget. Our budget balances. Our budget provides relief to families, many of whom are living paycheck to paycheck. We hold Washington accountable, reduce wasteful spending, and set our nation on a path to prosperity. The status quo is not working, and Democrats need to stop pretending that it is. It is our legal obligation to pass a budget. While the Senate Democrats seem to require having their paychecks on the line to pass a budget, House Republicans have fulfilled the obligation to pass a budget every year since taking the majority. I want to thank Chairman Ryan and his committee for their hard work to ensure that this happens.
Good morning. This week is a defining week. It's one of those weeks that defines the difference and the contrast between a Democrat-controlled Congress and a Republican-controlled Congress. We will put forth both of our ideas. Ours will a budget that balances, that has economic growth, that puts the future into a path for prosperity. The Democrat proposal, $1.8 trillion in taxes, never balances. More of the malaise of what we see. And I listened to the other side. They think it's more about politics than policy. But I would say maybe they ought to listen to the American people. You look at the latest AP poll, 51% of Americans want Congress controlled by Republicans based upon a budget that actually moves forward, and only 37% say for Democrats. This week, as you watch the vote, we'll have the president's budget up, the Democrats' budget up, and ours. Which one balances? Which one has economic growth? And what does their side do? More taxes with no balance.
Good morning. I'm sure you're aware that today is Equal Pay Day. And as a woman, and as one that has two daughters, I've always supported equal pay for equal work, as have all of us. And what we're promoting as Republicans are those policies that are going to empower women and everyone, give people freedom, the flexibility, jobs, higher paychecks, and the opportunity for a better life. And all you have to do is look at last week's jobs report, where you see that the president's policies are having the exact opposite impact. What you see are those policies that are actually creating more unemployment for women, less opportunities for job growth, and less opportunities for a higher paycheck. So on this year's Equal Pay Day, I wanted to just celebrate and highlight the important role that women are playing in our economy. When you look at the fact that 47% of the workforce now are women, and that they make most of America's consumer spending decisions. 2 out of 3 small businesses right now are being started by women. They're the majority of our healthcare workers, as well as 85% of healthcare decisions are made by women. So women understand the direct impact of the policies and the impact that they have on them. So on this Equal Pay Day, I would urge us to stop politicizing women and let's start focusing on those policies that are actually going to help women and everyone in this country have a better life. Let's focus on those policies that are actually going to move forward on a jobs plan that will create a higher paycheck, more opportunities, and that opportunity for a better life, which we all want.
Democrats want you to believe that Republicans do not support women in their efforts to be successful, as if conservatives who believe in less government, fair taxes, personal responsibility, and freedom are unwilling to support my mom, my sister, my daughter, or me. So please allow me to set the record straight. We strongly support equal pay for equal work. And I'm proud that I live in a country where it's illegal to discriminate in the workplace, thanks to the Equal Pay Act of 1963 and the Civil Rights Act of 1964. Some folks don't understand that women have become an extremely valuable part of the workforce today on their own merits, not because the government mandated it. Today, women represent almost half the workforce. They receive more BAs, more MAs, and PhD than men. When it comes to employment, the fact is many women seek jobs that provide more flexibility for their families over more money, which is the choice that I made as a young working mom. It was my choice, and I don't understand why Democrats won't respect my choices. I can tell you the most important issue for women are a healthy economy and jobs, a good education system, lower health care costs, and affordable energy. And those are the issues that Republicans in the House have already found solutions for, such as the Save American Workers Act, the Skills Act, the RAINS Act, the STEMS Job Act, or the dozens of other jobs bills that we've passed, but the Democrat-controlled Senate won't take up to help hardworking women succeed. Many ladies I know feel like they are being used as pawns and find it condescending that Democrats are trying to use this issue as a political distraction from the failures of their economic policies.
This week marks the fourth year in a row that House Republicans will pass a budget to balance the budget and pay off the debt. We believe that this is our obligation to our fellow citizens to get our government to live within its means. A country that lives beyond its means today is a country that will necessarily have to live below its means tomorrow. And we do not want to do that to our children and our grandchildren. We actually asked the CBO, what are the economic effects of our budget? They analyzed it and they said it will increase economic output by 1.8%, which translates into more take-home pay for people to the tune of $1,100 at the end of the day. Getting government to live within its means, balancing the budget, paying off the debt is good for economic growth. Here's the problem. We are 5 years into Obamanomics and the economy is not improving. CBO just told us from last year to this year, they have downgraded their projections of economic growth. And as a result, $1.2 trillion in higher deficits. As a result, we now have an administration and House Democrats saying, let's just do more of that same policies that are lowering our economic projections. The Democrats are saying, let's raise taxes again by $1.8 trillion. Let's raise spending by over $700 billion. Let's follow the president's lead in hollowing out our military. We disagree with that. We want a strong military. We want a balanced budget. We want faster economic growth. That's why we're calling for things like tax reform, more energy development, better job training reforms. We want to make sure that we can get the people back to work, raise take-home pay, and get our government to live within our means so that we can live a good life in the future and that people can get jobs and better take-home pay. And that's why we're passing this budget. We need to lead. We can't just duck responsibility. That's what others would like to do around here. That's why we're passing this budget.